Remember how I said to never forget where you come from? Your ancestry, your circumstances, your culture, how it all frames who you are. These are the moments where I'm reminded who I am.
Darling, I care for you.
What's this one?
Oh, more than my own.
The Titan again.
Darling, yeah. I share.
This is Jamaica, part two. My mom's side of the family is from St. Elizabeth, or country as we call it, 3 hours south of Montego Bay, one of the oldest parishes in the island.
Hello? Hi. Good morning. No, we're not. All right, we need to come inside and I can't get in.
Can't get in?
No. Good morning. I'm Vida on the back of the garden around there.
The next garden man should come around back.
What's it like growing ganja in Jamaica?
It's like you're on a vacation.
All the time, huh?
Yeah, you're on a vacation while you're producing marijuana.
Yeah.
It's the happiest time of your life.
It's a dream job, huh?
Yeah, when you interact with the plants, it brings you to a high note where the happiest you can be.
Yes.
Yeah.
Let me see. Mm, yeah.
You're interacting with lemon. You smell the lemon, right?
Oh, wow. It's very citrusy.
Yeah.
It smells good.
Yeah, I don't want nobody knows it.
It's all produced by love.
All produced by love.
Nothing negative around this. If something negative is, it's just like you're spoiled in the whole mood.
Understood.
Once something negative come around and plant, yeah, the whole mood is plant. Just fear.
It's
because
respect.
It's the closest plant to human being. You have male and female. Two of them.
My hands are like.
And soap cannot wash it off of your hand.
You see that? Hold on, look. We farm way more than ganja, however. St. Elizabeth is known as the breadbasket of the country for the supply of farmlands producing fruits, veggies, and agriculture.
Like when I look so rough and I go up on video, I don't like that. My daughter see me and say, Daddy.
What you working with?
String bean.
String bean?
Yes.
Nice. All of this?
Yes, go right up the top here.
What do you mean, our boy?
It's not a lot.
Let me go interview Uncle Matthew, okay?
Okay.
Love you.
Love you too, baby.
See you later.
God bless.
Thank you. Oh, it feels thicker than that.
Darling, I care.
But it's not all work and no play in St. Elizabeth. There's lots of fun and attractions to visit too. Like here at Wyeth Falls, a community tourism spot that hosts a beautiful waterfall, three pools, zip lining, and more.
can have just one night, or we can have one whole life. If we play the mood, yeah. We can have that one thing, or we can have everything. If our hearts are open, girls, go down. Girl, I love
And there's also Lover's Leap, a gorgeous horizon and landscape that honors one of Jamaica's most infamous love story. It's a tale of two enslaved people, Mizzy and Tunky, who jump to their death in a bid to escape their slave owner and stay together. Above all though, Saint Elizabeth holds my fondest memories of home and family. Lime to make limeade. Yeah. The history I know most about dates back to generations. My mom's side of the family is huge. My grandmother had 12 siblings, and all those siblings had children with siblings, and then those children had children with more siblings, and the list just goes on. My great-grandma and grandpa and a few other family members are actually buried in the backyard. Burying loved ones on home property is customary around these parts, so don't get afraid.
So Estelle Lloyd is my grandmother. She's my mother's mother. And this is my grandfather, Rupert Lloyd.
But it doesn't just start from my grandmother. We can actually go back as far as the story of her grandmother and her sisters, slave masters from Europe, most likely Irish, with names like Cotty, Haggy, and Tootle. Brother Mackie, my grandma's first cousin, his dad was her dad's brother, shares a bit of the history of the sisters who started us all.
I can see the family in us.
Yeah.
Really, really lovely. I was born in the Lloyd's family. The quality of Mama Cartier, Aunt Aggie, you haven't seen photographs of them?
Not yet.
I have photographs. I think I have.
They're, if you look on them, they are more British and more Scottish than...
In the 23andMe, it had told me I was 70% West African. And then it said I was 27% British and Irish. And it broke down Irish, like some 12% out of the British and Irish. So however you add up to get that, that's how it got there. We're doing the research and looking it up, and I was like, dang, like that makes so much sense about Southfield, because you know they always talk about how the people out here are so high color.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm so proud to be a Jamaican. I mean, you can't change history, but you can choose how to let it all affect you.
I got one nice watch, so you know.
I don't talk about the watch in the session.
The uniqueness of my island is engraved in my very being, a constant reminder of how I came to be.
Hi. Good morning. How are you?
Not bad. How you doing?
I'm fine. I'm full of visitors. I'm going to put you in the picture of my mother.
But they're right at the front of the scheme. They go behind the scheme. It's behind it. They're right at the front. They don't know my passage. A year's long enough.
Stop.
Come out.
Okay.
Yes, baby. Yes, you can't come out this way. Oh boy.
Alright.
It's alright. And although I don't always get it right, I'll continue to adapt and learn and appreciate all that continues to come my way. Until next time, Jamaica.